6th स्टैंडर्ड स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट फ्रॉम पेज नंबर 236. व्हाट इज एन इक्वेशन? लेट अस रिकॉल द मैजेस्टिक पैटर्न्स ऑफ द लेटर एल गिवन इन द फिगर 11.1. ऑलरेडी वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट दिस पैटर्न. फॉर आर कन्वीनियंस वी हैव द फिगर 11.1 रीड ऑन हियर. ओके, टू मैजेस्टिक्स, जनरल फॉर्मूला 2n. The number of matchsticks required for different number of L's formed was given in the table 1. We repeat the table here. For 1, 2 matchsticks we are using. For 2, 4, for 3, 6, for 4, 8. And in this way, so on. We know that the number of matchsticks required is given by the rule 2n if n is taken to be the number of L's formed. Appu always thinks differently. He asked, we know how to find the number of matchsticks required for a given number of L's. What about the other way? So, what about the other way round? How does one find the number of L's formed given the number of matchsticks? Suppose that number of matchsticks are given. Now we have to calculate how many L's we can formed by using those number of matchsticks. Then what we will do? We ask ourselves a definite question. How many L's are formed if the number of matchsticks given is 10? So for 1 we are using 2 in this way. So from this table again we will check this table for 10, 9, 18 and for 10. 20. And if 10 matchsticks are there, then how many L's we can form here? You can see 5. So, how many L's are formed if the number of matchsticks given is 10? This means we have to find the number of L's, that is N, given the number of matchsticks 10. So, see here, number of L's we don't know, number of matchsticks we know. General formula 2n. So what we can do here? Here we have a condition to be satisfied by the variable n. Suppose that if n, we are putting here 1. So 2 ones are 2. 2 equal to 10? No. So this condition is not satisfied. The next number in place of n, 2. 2 twos are 4. 4 is not equal to 10. 3, 6 is not equal to 10. 4. Not equal, 2 4s are 8, not equal to 10. Then 5, 2 5s are 10, 10. Both are equal. So n equal to 5. That means this condition is an example of an equation. Our question can be answered by looking at table 1. Look at various values of n. If n equal to 1, the number of matchsticks is 2. Clearly the condition is not satisfied because 2 is not 10. We go on checking. See here. 2, 4, 3, 6. So, condition not satisfied. And when we are putting 5, condition is satisfied. We find that only if n equal to 5, the condition, that is the equation 2n equal to 10, is satisfied for any value n other than 5. The equation is not satisfied. Let us look the another equation. Now see, Balu is 3 years younger than Raju. Whatever age Raju is, 3 years younger Balu's age. So if Raju's age x, then Balu's age will be x minus 3 years. If Balu's age is x, Raju's age will be x plus 3 years, because Raju is 3 years elder than Balu. Taking Raju's age to be x years, Balu's age is x minus 3 years. Suppose Balu's is 11 years old. Then let us see how our method gives Raju's age. We have Balu's age x minus 3 equal to 11. Balu's age. And in the algebraic expressions, Raju's age, suppose that x, Balu is 3 years younger than x minus 3. So x minus 3 equal to 11 years. This is an equation in the variable x. We shall prepare a table of values x minus 3 for various values of x. See here, equal sign is there. So it is called algebraic equation. Complete the entries which are left blank from the table. We find only for x equal to 14, the condition x minus 3 equal to 11 is satisfied. Let's see. If we will put here 1, so 1 minus 2, sorry, 1 minus 3, that is minus 2, minus 2 is not equal to 11. Equation is not satisfied. If 2 minus 3 minus 1 and age never be negative number. Now 3 minus 3, 0, not possible because 11 years, Balu's age is 11 years. Then 4 minus 3, 1, 5 minus 3, 2, 6 minus 3, 3, 7 minus 3, 4. So in this way, when we will put 14, 14 minus 3, 11. So X, we assume Raju's age. So Raju is 14 years old and Balu is 11 years old. Equation satisfied. For which value? X equal to 40. For other values, for example, for X equal to 16 or for X equal to 12. If 16 minus 3. So 16 minus 3, 13. 13 is not equal to 11. For 12, 12 minus 3 is 9. 9 is not equal to 11. The condition is not satisfied. Raju's age, therefore, Raju's age is 14 years. To summarize, any equation like the above is a condition on a variable. It is satisfied only for a definite value of the variable. So many values we take, but condition is that equation only satisfied for a definite value. Here the definite value is 14. Now, suppose the equation 2n equal to 10 is satisfied only by the value of phi, the variable n. So, 2 into n, that means 2 into phi. So, 2 into phi is 10, RHS and LHS equal. So, for n equal to phi, this equation is satisfied. Similarly, the equation x minus 3 equal to 11 is satisfied only by the value 14 of the variable x. Note that an equation has an equal sign. We have seen between its two sides. The equation says that the value of the left hand side, that means LHS, is equal to the value of the right hand side, that means RHS. If the LHS is not equal to RHS, we do not get an equation. Clear? In the equation, equal sign should be there. And for a definite value, LHS equal to RHS should be there. For example, the statement 2n is greater than 10. It is not an equation because here is not equal sign. Similarly, the statements 2n is smaller than 10, not an equation. X minus 3 greater than 11, no. X minus 3 less than 11, no. Let us consider 8 minus 3 equal to 5. So we know LHS 8 minus 3 equal to 5. So LHS is equal to RHS, but it is numerical equation. Here is no unknown value. Here is not any variable. There is an equal sign between the LHS and RHS. Neither of the two sides contain a variable. Both contain numbers. We may call this a numerical equation. Usually the word equation is used only for equations with one or more variables. At least one variable should be in equation, or more than one variable may be there. Let us do an exercise. State which of the following are equations with a variable. In the case of equations with a variable, identify the variable. Okay. Variable is x. Numerical equation. Variable, not an equation. Equation. Variable is n. Equation. Variable is b, not an equation. Following are some examples of an equation. The variable in the equation is also identified. All are equations. Here the variable is x, here p, here n, here t, here l, here m. Now, solution of an equation. We saw in earlier section that the equation 2n equal to 10. When n equal to 5, so 2 into 5, 2 5s are 10. So, LHS n equal to RHS. So, this equation is satisfied by n equal to 5. No other value of n satisfies the equation. The value of variable is an equation which satisfies the equation is called the solution of the equation. That means n equal to 5 is the solution of the equation. If we will put value except 5 in place of n, we will not get solution because LHS will not be equal to RHS. If n equal to 6 is not a solution to the equation, 2n equal to 10, because for n equal to 6, 2 into 6 equal to 12, 12 and not equal to 10. Also n equal to 4 is not a solution because 2 into 4, 2n, so 2 into 4 equal to 8, 8 is not equal to 10. Let us take the equation x minus 3 equal to 11. This equation is satisfied by x equal to 14. If we will put value other than 14, LHS will not be equal to RHS. Suppose that x equal to 16. 16 minus 3. 16 minus 3 is 13, which is not equal to RHS. Thus, x equal to 14 is a solution to the equation x minus 3 equal to 11, and x equal to 16 is not a solution to the equation. Also, x equal to 12. If we will put in place of x 12, so 12 minus 3 is 9. 9 is not equal to 11. So, 12 is not a solution to the equation here. Now, complete the entries in the following table and explain why your answer is yes or no. In finding the solution to the equation 2n equal to 10, we prepared a table for various values of n, and from the table, we picked up the value of n which was the solution to the equation, which satisfies the equation. What we used, a trial and error method. This method is called trial and error method. It is not a direct and a practical way of finding a solution of the equation. Now let's see. Equation x plus 10 equal to 30. If we will put here x equal to 10, because value is given, value of the variable x equal to 10. So 10 plus 10 equal to 20, not equal to RHS. RHS is 30. So x equal to 10 is not the solution of the x plus 10 equal to 30. Now here, if we will put in place of x 30, so 30 plus 10 in the second question, 30 plus 10 equal to 40, 40 not equal to 30. So no, x plus 10 equal to 30. Now 20 plus 10 equal to 30, so yes. Same way, p minus 3 equal to 7, so 5 minus 3, 2, 2 not equal to 7, so no. P minus 3 equal to 7, p equal to 15, 15 minus 3 is 12, no. P minus 3 equal to 7, 10, 10 minus 3 equal to 7, yes. 3n equal to 20, 1, n equal to 9, 3 9s are 27, 27 is not equal to 21, so no. Now n equal to 7, 3 into 7, 21, so yes. T upon 5 equal to 4, so T equal to 25. 25 upon 5, 5 5s are 25. 5 is not equal to 4, so no. T equal to 20, 20 divided by 5, 4 times, yes. 2L plus 3 equal to 7, L equal to 5. So first multiply 5 by 2, so 2L, so 2 into 5, 10. 10 plus 3, 13. 13 is not equal to 7, so no. L equal to 1, so 2 1s are 2, 2 plus 3, 5, 5 is not equal to 7, so no. Now L equal to 2, so 2 2s are 4, 4 plus 3 equal to 7, so yes. L equal to 2 is the solution of the equation 2L plus 3 equal to 7. We need a direct way of solving an equation, that is finding the solution of the equation. We shall learn a more systematic method of solving equations only next year. That means in the next year, in the 7th standard, you will learn the systematic method, how we can find the solution of the equation. And on the previous page, we have discussed trial and error method. It is not a standard method to find the solution of the equation because it is lengthy and time consuming method. Now, beginning of algebra. It is said the algebra as a branch of mathematics begun about 1550 BC, that is more than 3500 years ago, when people in Egypt started using symbols to denote unknown numbers. Around 300 BC, use of letters to denote unknowns and forming expressions from them was quite common in India. Many great Indian mathematicians, Aryabhatta, Brahmagupt, Mahavir and Bhaskar and others contributed a lot of the study of algebra. They gave names such as Bij, Varna, that means Bij Ganit, Varna Ganit, because we are using here alphabetical letters now. But हमारे जो mathematicians हैं पहले इंडिया के, उन्होंने उसको अपनी लैंग्वेज में इन द प्योर हिंदी और इन द संस्कृत लैंग्वेज उन्होंने उसको बीज गणित या इस तरह के नाम दिए. टू अननोन्स एंड यूज फर्स्ट लेटर ऑफ कलर नेम्स, वो कलर नेम्स का फर्स्ट लेटर भी यूज करते थे. का फ्रॉम कला ब्लैक काला, नी फ्रॉम नीला ब्लू, टू डिनोट देम अननोन नंबर्स. द इंडियन नेम टू अलजेब्रा बीज गणित, डेट्स बैक टू दीज एशियन इंडियन मैथमेटिशियंस. द वर्ड अलजेब्रा इज डेराइव्ड फ्रॉम द टाइटल ऑफ द बुक अलजेब्र वल अलमुगबला, पता नहीं, रिटन अबाउट 825 AD बाय एन अरब मैथमेटिशियंस मोहम्मद इबन अल ख्वारिज्मी ऑफ बगदाद. नाउ इट इज द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ अलजेब्रा ओनली. ओके, लेट अस स्टार्ट एक्सरसाइज 11.5 नाउ.